Hi, here in the COVID bat cave, the remote mortgage office for almost a year now, thanks to COVID. And COVID may be sort of the side story to what's going on this week with mortgage rates, in case you haven't heard. Fixed rate mortgages are going up and quite promptly. So they've gone up so far this week anywhere from 0.1 to 0.4%. And some lenders, I think by the time we get through this coming weekend here, some lenders will have raised their fixed rates three times. Why? Bonds. The yields for the bonds that influence pricing for fixed rate mortgages, those yields have gone cuckoo, and lenders have no choice but to bake those costs in and pass them along to borrowers like you and I. So you're seeing these fixed rates go up. If you've got a fixed rate mortgage on your property already, there's nothing to worry about, there's no change. If you have a variable rate mortgage on your house, there's nothing to worry about because nothing has changed there. And that's kind of the point of this video today. You'll see that a lot of lenders have increased their fixed rate mortgages, and I can think of one that's big and green. And in fact, if you point at them specifically, they've increased their fixed rate mortgages, the 5-year fixed, today by 0.25%. Whereas on the variable rate mortgages, they actually lowered their rate by 0.2% to the lowest I've ever seen their rates be for a variable. So I've always been a big preacher of the variable rate mortgage because historically they've been lower rates than fixed, and that's showing to be the case this week. They are the king of optionality because if you go to break your mortgage in the middle of its term, like so many Canadians do, the penalty for breaking a variable is significantly lower than breaking a fixed by and large. And you got to hand it to the variable rate mortgage in the middle of a global pandemic. Because when the fit hit the shan, almost exactly a year ago, nothing went down faster than the prime rate for mortgages. Canadians with variable rate mortgages, and HELOCs for that matter, saw their interest rate go down 1.5% in 5 weeks. And now that things are maybe starting to turn around, and you see that change manifest in mortgage rates, fixed rates are shooting, and not only is variable staying put, but it's actually in some cases going down. So long live the variable, and keep the variable in the center of your mind if you're considering purchasing or refinancing a home in the near future. If you need any help with that, you know who to call.